You know, in the second chapter, it says in the first verse and the second and the third verse, A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitan Rajeem, Bismillah Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Alif Lam Mim, Zalikal Kitabu La Raiba Fihi, Hudan Lil Muttaqeen. This is the book of guidance, but for those people who have the muttaqi, who are the muttaqi people? Who has the taqwa? And what is taqwa? A shield. You have to have a shield over here. You have to know, you have to know what is wrong and what is right. You have to have a taqwa and you have to know how to fight with that. And you cannot fight with that until you have a connection with Allah. You cannot fight with that. You know, I remember the verse in chapter 7, Surah Al-A'raf, from verse number 16 to 18, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rejected Iblis. What did Iblis told Allah? He said, فَبِمَا أَغْوَيْتَنِي لَا أَكْوَدَنْ لَلُمْ سِرَاتَكَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ ثُمَّا لَعَاتِيَنَّمْ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِهِمْ وَمِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ وَعَنْ إِمَانِهِمْ وَعَنْ شِمَالِهِمْ وَلَا تَجِدُ أَكْثَرَهُمْ شَاكِرِينَ. He said, I am going to attack everyone from the right, from the left, from the front, and from the back. He said, I'm going to attack from everywhere. Now who could answer me that? How are you going to survive? Who's going to answer me that? Come on, kids. From you. Now there's a long explanation when he said, I'm going to attack from the right, from the left, and from the front. So it has a long philosophy behind there, actually. It's like one word it says in the Quran, but it has a very deep meaning. Like from the right side. That's from when you have a taqwa, he's going to attack you. From the left side, to put you into the scene. And from the front, that's like akhira. And from the back, he make you forget what happened to the people in your history. He make them forget everything to make you sin. So how are you going to survive with that if he's going to attack you from everywhere? Who's going to answer me that? Come here, come here. What's your name?
Tamim.
I'm not going to hold for you, man. Come on,
Tamim.
Hold it. What?
Tamim.
Talk to people over there. I'm training you right now, so when you be bigger, you're going to be at my place, inshallah. Say inshallah. All right. So Shaitan is saying, I'm going to attack you from everywhere. Explain me, how are you going to survive?
You can survive by...
Come on, speak loud. I don't hear you. Can anybody hear me?
Prostrating to Allah and reading the Quran and doing everything that...
Can anyone can understand him?
Yes.
Commanded by...
Good.
You said, read it louder. Read it more louder.
I think you should prostrate to Allah, you should read the Quran, you should do everything that was commanded by Him. And this way you can avoid them, because whenever they see you do sajda, they get scared because they can't handle the humiliation that they've had in like the beginning, where they had to prostrate to Adam alayhissalam. And that's why I think you should do that.
Alright, some of the answer was right, so I'll give you candy. Take it something from me, okay? MashaAllah, good. Alright, the answer is, Shaitan is attacking you from everywhere. But regardless, how smart is he still forgot something. He forgot something. There was a escape hole that was up there and below. And what does that mean when you say like above there and beneath? How is that? That's like having a strong connection with Allah. In your ibadah, stop sinning. But in order to stop sinning, you have to get the knowledge. Because let's say there's many people who've been sinning a whole life without even realizing they are sinning. Until you get something later on, somebody comes to you and he will say, oh, okay, you were doing this in, oh, astaghfirullah, I didn't even know that. Okay, good, they find something on the later age. And what I said, the next escape hole, that is on the ground. You have to stay in a humble way. You have to stay humble to Allah. Because if you're humble to Allah, you're being sincere to Allah, keep yourself down into the place where God bring you from. That is from the dust. Allah says, stay in a dust. Do not try to bring an ego in you. Don't try to do that, because these things always are utilized and operated by Shaitan. And it's the best weapon to make a fitna in the earth. And the next thing is, make your connection strong with Allah. And that's through the ibadah. with having the taqwa. And then rest, we still cannot rely on this thing. We still have to rely on the mercy of Allah. We have to still rely on that. We cannot do that. And okay,